And welcome back to Hannity. Now, the New Hampshire primary is only hours away. A brand new Emerson College poll shows that former Florida Governor Jeb Bush is now in second place. Donald Trump is 31%. Bush has 16. He has a lead over John Kasich, Marco Rubio, and Ted Cruz. Joining us now, 2016 Republican presidential candidate, former Florida Governor Jeb Bush. I guess that's saying don't count you out.
It's going to be an interesting evening tomorrow night. There's a lot of grassroots activity on our team, and everybody else is working hard as well. We've knocked on 100,000 doors in this state.
100,000 doors.
With volunteers, a lot of people from out of state, and a lot of people here. It's how you do it in New Hampshire. I think people respect the retail politics here a lot, and I've enjoyed it. I did about 100 different kinds of meetings where I was answering questions. I got better at it. I mean, I learned. You learn along the way, and it's.
You say you got better, but I would think as governor, because you were the governor that answered everybody's email. That's how I got an interview with you when you were governor. I sent you an email. I just took a shot.
Yeah, but it's interesting. You just learn. There's a context that kind of develops, and the questions that people ask. It added a. I don't know. I found it interesting. For those that think that the first in the nation primary status should be removed, I totally disagree after going through this.
Isn't it hard? I was asking Trump about this today. Isn't it hard to see all these people out of work, in poverty, on food stamps? It drives me nuts. We doubled the debt, home ownership at a low. I'm like, what are we doing here?
We had had 700 people at town hall meeting on Saturday, and a daughter of a guy who was there told the story of how she got a death certificate from her father, or his father, you know, her father died, according to the Department of Veterans Affairs, but the benefits kept coming inside the Veterans Affairs, but Social Security and Medicaid were cut off. I mean, this is just, and it took 9 months to get it fixed.
Yeah.
These are the stories you hear. These are real people with real concerns.
And the people out of work, and the people on
working part-time,
right.
Having a woman that I met that is living paycheck to paycheck, paid the fine rather than, you know, the mandated benefits. She couldn't afford the co-payments
for
Obamacare.
Yeah.
This is the story that's played out, and it just validates the belief that we need major change in Washington.
You just came from Portsmouth. You came from a shipyard. My reporter for my radio show, Jamie Dupree, on the ground said you had overflow crowds all weekend and turning people away. So what's the difference between Iowa and here? And this poll, obviously, you're pretty happy about.
We've worked hard here. We've worked really hard here, and I went and campaigned in Iowa. This is a place where I've spent more time. The national security issues are important here. Veterans issues are more important here. We have Donald Trump today said that we don't need to spend more money on defense. It's the one place we need to spend more money, and so making that case about being a commander in chief in dangerous times has been helpful.
Do you think that this is breaking out, as analysts say, between the insurgency candidates and an establishment? I can tell by your look, you're not buying this at all. Do you think it's breaking down? In other words, like, everybody seems to think there's going to be that one governor, you, Christie, or Kasich, or Marco Rubio, that pulls through, quote, on that establishment lane. Do you buy that argument or not? You think it's baloney?
I just kind of think you got to go earn it, and you got to go do it, and it'll kind of sort out organically rather than how the pun. I mean, I've been written off. I've seen obituaries written about myself, and like the guy from the town hall meeting, I'm still alive.
But after Iowa, does that get you down because it's not where you want it to be?
No, not at all, because I did feel good about this, and we'll see how it plays out tomorrow, but I'm heading Wednesday morning. I'm in Hilton Head, South Carolina.
You're in this Super Tuesday. You're in this to the end. The debate on Saturday night to me was one of the more interesting debates because it was like an assault on your friend Marco Rubio.
Chris Christie assaulting.
Yeah,
I didn't do much.
I pissed him off once because I said he hugged Obama and he got mad at me. I didn't hug him. I'm like, all right, whatever.
Look, it's one of those just rare moments where a narrative had been built up and then it was validated by the candidate himself. Fair or unfair, that's just the way it is.
And this is a blood sport. I try to tell people they don't like the infighting right now, but isn't it just the reality you have to accept every 4 years?
I mean, Marco complains that people are my super PAC's attacking him. Well, his super PAC's attacking me. I mean, it's just the nature of the beast. And frankly, we need to all toughen up. Whoever's going to be the nominee, can you imagine what the Clinton hit machine looks like? They have nothing to offer other than tearing down the Republican.
They're even accusing poor Bernie Sanders of being a sexist. That's how desperate they are right now.
Yeah, they're just chomping at the bit to get after someone. I think a proven record would be helpful in that regard.
Last question. Yeah. So this poll is encouraging to you.
Yeah.
You think you can pull second and surprise the...
I don't know. I think it's very volatile. It's a jump ball. There's five candidates. Looks like, you know, Trump's ahead, but who knows? You know, it's hard to tell how New Hampshire. They're an independent spirit, that's for sure. So we'll see how it plays out.
Live free or die, Governor. Great to see you. Thanks for stopping by. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Sean.